How are you doing today?
Awesome. How are you?
Doing great. So who am I here with today?
My name is Joshua McLean. I am the owner operator, or I should say co-owner operator of Cut Up and Sew. My wife is the other half who's at home with our three-year-old today.
Okay. What would you say you are to your customers in the retail?
Yeah, I thought about that question. My initial answer is always I'm a friend, but I wanted to tweak it a little bit. I'm more of a friendly expert. I offer support. I offer supplies, machines, but I also offer literally a friendly place for them to hang out, to socialize with their friends, with myself, with the staff, where we can learn things together, because I learn stuff from them all the time, but also just a place that people can come and socialize and enjoy common interests, which happens to be sewing and quilting and embroidery and all that other fun stuff. So a friendly expert's final answer.
All right. When you started your business, what motivated you originally?
I had been in the industry for 6 years or so. And my wife and I wanted a change of scenery, and I fell in love with the industry, and we decided we wanted to do it for ourselves. So we put the feelers out, found this place, and pulled the trigger. I love the idea of being able to support my family and basically make money doing something that I love. So that was the motivation.
All right. And what is the biggest challenge you ever encountered in your business?
It's all the behind the scenes stuff. I'm a people person, so I like hanging out with the customers, with my new friends, you know, and I like talking about machines and showing machines and sewing and doing all that. So I love the sales part of it, but it's the behind the scenes stuff. You know, as an owner, there's the things that you don't think about. So for me, it was putting on that hat, the ordering, the, you know, all the technical stuff, the business side of it. So that for me was the biggest personal challenge, is the biggest personal challenge.
And what was the effect on you and your life?
We literally relocated. So big change, especially having my son Casper, who's a three-year-old, uprooting him entirely. I think that was the biggest challenge. But, you know, also it gave us some freedom. You know what I mean? Like there were some challenges, but also there's a lot of perks. Being the owner, you know, I can close at a certain time and go home and turn my brain off. It's been amazing, to be honest with you. It's been awesome. So the whole experience has been great.
Nice. And how did you overcome that?
Well, so I guess the challenge of uprooting, you know, my son was you adapt. That's the easy answer. That's the short answer.
Okay.
You figure it out. Honestly, we have been welcomed with open arms, and so it's been pretty easy to feel at home, to make Palm Coast our new home. It's been really easy, honestly too easy. I'm still waiting for like a red flag or something, but I don't know if it's there. So it naturally happened. You know?
All right. What is the biggest achievement in running your business to date?
Yeah, our grand reopening. We had on January the 8th, we had only had 2 months to prepare for it. But we had an official grand reopening. We literally redid the entire store. We opened up, we expanded. We changed the logo. So we re-signed the building. And we had to promote that in a fairly short amount of time. And the turnout was insane. We did a big ribbon cutting ceremony. I bought a pair of giant scissors, which are around here somewhere. But and it was primarily because I've always wanted to do that. But we had a huge crowd and everybody was there cheering and welcoming. It was awesome. It was so busy that it was kind of a blur, but it was super successful. And that is going to be one that sticks with me forever.
Okay.
Yeah, it was awesome.
So when your customers come into the store, and how do you you and your staff make them feel after they leave?
Oh, that's easy. Good. I mean, honestly, happy. So the first thing is, and it's not really the answer to the question, but you got to smile. I always tell people being nice is the easy part, and that so many shops make that mistake, and I'm not naming names or anything, but being nice, genuinely enjoying people's company, when they come in, we, you know, greet them with open arms. So when they leave, I mean, unless I chase after them and ask them how they feel, I don't know, but you can tell that they feel like they want to come back. You know what I mean? They were like, yeah, that's a spot that I can call my local shop or whatever. And so good, happy, whatever.
Okay.
Yeah.
Tell us a story about a successful customer experience that comes to mind for you on the top of your head.
So there's so many, and I shared one about a multi-needle and one of my emails. I think I'm gonna share it again just because this is a video and so I can actually explain it a little bit more. There was a young lady, this was up in Louisville, Kentucky, and she was trying to, of course, we're in the middle of a pandemic, COVID, and so, but she wanted to start an embroidery business. Embroidery machines can be fairly expensive. So she made the choice to purchase a pre-owned machine. Unfortunately, the pre-owned machine was a dud, if you will. So she brought it in for service and I had to give her the bad news that it's gonna cost more than it's worth to fix it. And so I'm trying to figure out a way for her to trade it in because we do that here in the industry. And the machine she had her eye on, which you'll see later, you know, was honestly out of her price range. So, but I really wanted, you know, I got a soft spot. So I really wanted to help her out. So one of our educators, a good friend of mine, I knew she had a machine that she didn't use a lot, but it was basically brand new. So I called in a favor and we were able to get her the machine of her dreams, essentially, for a price that worked for her. Just by my friend doing me a solid, in which case I then paid it forward to her. She ended up immediately, well, obviously she was thrilled and happy, and we were all happy, everybody wins, but she made enough money in a short amount of time that she literally traded in her machine to buy her dream machine, the 10 needle, because she was making enough money that she could afford it. I mean, I'm talking about a couple of months. So, and she was really talented, which is cool. Doesn't always work out that way, but the cool kind of set part of, I guess the side part of that story is that I was able to give my friend her machine back because I got it back. So everybody was literally happy. But the most important thing was that customer got her dream machine because we did something a little unorthodox and just, you know, think outside of the box and made it work. So I know I shared that in my email, but that one is probably my favorite because it was cool how it worked out. So
sounds like you truly care. That's really awesome.
Yeah, for real. Yeah. That's the easy part, though. That's what people, I never understand. I mean, like, we love this, that we're doing it. Yes, we got to pay the bills and everything, but I wouldn't be good at this if I didn't love it. And so that one was special.